Hey guys, welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to cover the fundamentals of pricing on AWS. So firstly, one of the components of pricing is compute. Here, you are charged for the amount of resources that you consume and the duration. So for example, if you launch an Amazon EC2 instance, you'll need to choose an instance type. The instance type defines the amount of CPU, RAM, and storage that's allocated to that instance. Now, for the CPU and RAM, you are charged based on the duration in which it's actually running. So if you run the instance for 24 hours, you will be charged, and it's actually a per minute basis. Now, on the other hand, if you shut down the instance, you're no longer paying for the CPU and RAM, but you might be paying for the storage. So storage is based on the quantity of data stored or allocated. So it does depend on the service here. For example, with Amazon S3, you are charged on the amount of data that's stored. If you have a gigabyte of data, you pay for a gigabyte. If you have a terabyte, you pay for a terabyte. Now, with Amazon EBS, that's the Elastic Block Store, that's actually the volumes that are attached to EC2 instances. There, you're actually charged for the amount of allocated space. So you might create an EBS volume that's a gigabyte in size, but it doesn't have much data in it, maybe just a few hundred megabytes. You still pay for the full size of that storage volume. The third element is outbound data transfer. This is the quantity of data that's transferred out. That means out of an availability zone or a region. So you've really got to understand this. This is something where companies can get a little bit tripped up. You never pay for data that you transfer into the cloud, but you do pay for data that's transferred out of an availability zone or a region. So you've got to understand the various different charges there, because they can actually amount to quite a bit of money if you're transferring large quantities of data. Now, we've got a few different frameworks. One is pay-as-you-go, that's the default. This is where you're just paying for what you use, and that of course gives you lots of flexibility. You can easily adapt to changing business needs. You need 100 instances one day, only 10 the next day, no problem. Terminate the ones you don't need or shut them down, and now you're only paying for 10 instances. Here you can respond to change, of course, very easily and adapt based on needs and not on forecasts. Another pricing model is save when you reserve. That means that you're actually reserving capacity. For example, with RDS, with EC2, with the Elastic Compute Service, there's a variety of services which allow you to reserve capacity. Now, what you're doing here is you're committing for a period of time, 1 or 3 years. And that means that AWS are going to give you a discount. In fact, you can save up to 75% compared to the on-demand pricing. That's the pay-as-you-go pricing. The more you pay up front, the greater the discount. So for example, you can pay all of the amount up front, or sometimes you pay a partial amount up front, and then you pay some subsequent payments over a period of time. But in that case, the discount's not as great. So you're better off paying all up front if you can. There's then the concept of paying less when you use more. So here you get volume-based discounts. As an example, with Amazon S3, as you add more storage, you're paying a certain amount per gigabyte of data stored. But once you get to a certain threshold, any data above that threshold, the amount that you're paying per gigabyte reduces. And then there's a third threshold, for example. So as you store more and more data, the amount you're paying per unit of data, per gigabyte, for example, is decreasing. So that's a volume-based discount. You're being rewarded for utilizing these services. So it's tiered pricing, meaning the more you use, the lower the unit pricing.